Hello everyone, it's Anna from Anna's Paper Creations, and I have some cards to share with you. And this I made from the leftovers from the folios I made. So there I didn't use so much fussy cut and so then I decided to use them for some cards. And I used a beautiful Come Away With Me collection. And this is so great for traveling. And it is from Graphic 45. And I can maybe show you this first. This I filmed when I made it, so in the end of the video there will be a tutorial on how to make this. So I can take this out of the way. And this is a sort of a slider card. And this is not my ID. When I start scrapbooking, I started with cards, and this was some of the first I made. And I'm sorry, I don't remember where I saw it, so I'm not sure whose ID it was. So, but it slides up like so. So, hopefully you can see it here. And here inside you can write a personal message, and also on the top here. And also on the back side if you don't want to make it as a card. But I choose to make it as a card like so. So we'll also show you how to make that. So, and this I just glued on with some repositional glue, because I maybe will use this also to have some writing. So I see what I will use it for. So, and here is some acetate on an airplane here. So this was the one I filmed, and I also made some more. I made here this I got in a drink when I was traveling, so it's a, what do you call it, umbrella, sort of an umbrella. And yeah, and I popped up a Bon Voyage here, and a flower here, and this is from Wild Ogre Crafts flowers. So I just took this apart and used the two bottom layers, and then an open rose and some leaves that I colored with Lindy spray, Lindy stamp gang. So here you can see it's acetate here, so here I have some magnets to hold it close. So that's because if it would slide down because of the acetate. So I have a magnet behind here so it can stand. So hope you can see it all. And the umbrella can be taken out off or open like so. So it's a sort of mechanism inside here. So yeah. So thought that was a bit fun to use. So I think I will give this to my mom. We were traveling together, and she's also getting one of the folios I made. So, and the inside is like so, and the back side here with a tag and a postcard. Yeah. So, and then this third one I also. I think I will give this to my mom, because I used a chipboard from the collection here, and I placed a magnet here, and here is a picture of me and my mom when we were traveling. So, and yeah, a train peeking out here, and some pop dots I used on both this and the first one. And this is a flower from Petaloom, and the colors really match well with Graphic 45. And here it says Luftpost, and I'm not sure the language here, but it says the same in Norwegian. And then a stamp here that I curled up a bit. And an aeroplane here, and that's on some acetate. And here is how it works. So, and the aeroplane pops up. So, and I also have this open so I can place a tag inside here. Let's see if I can find one if I like to. Like so, and then inside, and I also can write a message here. And here it says, there is a kind of matchiness about going far away and then coming back all changed. And that's so true. This is also open, I think. No, I glued it all down. Okay, and the plane on the back here. So here I maybe can place a postcard behind me. So. All these cards are 6x4. So, and maybe show you the first one also. I'm not sure I told. I have aeroplane up here also on some acetate, so I will show how to make that. Then we can go on and I show you how to make this card here. Here I found an image that is 4x6 from the 12x12 paper pad, so I will use that. But here you also can make your own frame and make it any size you like to. So, and inside here is 4x2¾, I think. Yeah. So then we need to make an insert or slider inside. So here I've taken a piece of paper that is 5 by almost 2¾. I give it a bit of a room here because if you take it too tight here, it won't slide so easy. So then we need to score it at 1/2 inch and at 2½ inch and at 4½ inch. And then we can fold it like so and up with this. So that's the slider inside. So we can take this out of the way and then we can find ourselves an image here. Where I've taken a card and cut out so this measure all the same here, all the way up. And this I cut, you can take this the same width as this if you like to, but I like to have some backing when I drag it up. So this I cut at 3¾. And I also saved the top here on the paper. So then we can start to glue this together on the bottom. And here you can use any glue you like. I like to use this score tape that's 3/8 inch wide. So we can take this on here. So then I try to center it here. Here about. So now you see this goes up like so. And I also think I wanted to decorate here a bit, so I found a strip here, and this is from the 8x8 paper, I think. This also from 8x8, and this is from 12x12. So, I'll just glue this fast on here. So, take that on the bottom, slide this up, and take it all the way into the score line. Here about. So, and then we can fasten this on the card on the top. And here you can fasten it now, or you can fasten it after we take the backing on. So, I think maybe we can fasten it on now, so see how that goes. So then we will take some score tape here as well. And you can use any type of glue you like. I just love to use score tape. It's fast and it's a strong tape. So then we take this over here and see, line it up here. Right here. Yeah, I think that works. So then we can start working on the hinges to hold this together. So then we take the scoring board, and here I cut a piece of paper that is 5½ by 6½. And then we need to score it at 1/2 inch on 3 of the sides here. This will make the backing and also hinges to hold it together. So then I snip off the edge here, if you can see maybe. Oops, that was my glasses. Snip all the way up to the score line where they meet here. So, here. And then we can start folding this back. See if they meet up. should meet up here. No overlapping. And if it's a bit overlapping, you can just snip off a bit more. So then I take my score tape again. Just fold it over. Helps to keep the ends together here. So just folding it in an angle here. And then I also like to just snip off a bit here on the sides. So then we can glue this on here. So just open one side first here. So take this inside here, try to line it up. And then I take the other side. And fold this over this flap here. So this comes on the inside. It's more easy to do it when you lay down the card here, but then you will only see my hair because I need to have it close up. So now we can put the bottom here. So I messed it up a bit here, so I had to take it open again. So when I usually make these cards, I have them flat, and if this is the frame now, I start like this and glue it on the side here, and then I take my glue on, off on the side here, but I need to have it close up, so sorry for that. So it's better than doing it like this. So you get to see all my mistakes here. So here I found some images, and I also want to pop them up again a bit. And here I'm using 3D foam squares from Stick It, and this is a really affordable and glue pop dots. So these I bought here in Norway, but I think you can get them all over. So I think I will have this stamp on here popped up. And over here. And another one here. So I cut out all of it. It will be standing a bit on the outside. So if you are using a regular envelope for this, you maybe have to cut this off. I like to have it peeking out a bit. So, and then I also cut out this car here, and now I'm not sure, I think it was from the 8x8 paper. So then we will have some glue on here. And here I'm using a fine tip applicator, and this I got from finetip.co.uk. Take it in frame so you can see it. And here I used Scotch quick dry glue, and mix it with a bit of water. And I really like working with this fine tip here. So take this over here about, I think. And here. Yeah. So, and then this hot air balloon, and now I don't remember where I cut this out from either, but I think it was 12x12, and also placed some pop dots here. So, but all this you can lay flat if you like to. So I think I will have a bit on the side here, and I think I will cut this off. About. So, and you like to have something peeking out here, see, on the top, like so. So I just made some suggestions here. So here's a banner with hello. And this, I think, is a Sherry Lynn die. I also cut out another banner where I just wrote hello. So, but I will use this here. So just see how far it can go up. So I need to cut it off a bit. So here is some acetate. I just glued it on. And I also made glued some double acetate under here, so it pops up a bit. So if I take it here about, see how that works. Yeah, I can take it under here. So here I also will use some score tape, I think. You can use glossy accent or anything you like. Maybe I have to open these pop dots a bit again to get it under, so it doesn't show up all the way. Here about maybe, see? A bit lower down. So I think, yeah. And then we need to have some closure for it. And if you are using a magnet like I did on, if you are using an acetate, like here, it won't fall down by itself or stand by itself. So here I have a magnet under, and also on the back side here, if you can see the magnet here. So I will show you here. Then I glue this on the back side here, and place a magnet over here, and also one under here. So, but for this one, I just will glue it over here. So, we'll see. Take it on the top here. So, just glue a bit on the top here. And close it down. Melt in the middle. Here about. So. And then we can cut around it. If you're using another image that hasn't have this on the top, you can just glue on the hinge here. So, and maybe we'll have something in the inside also. So, let's see. Some images here, maybe this one, or I think I go for this one. So this I will glue all the way down. You could glue it only on the side and have a tag peeking like so, but I think I will have it open here for a message. So. Then you can write a message to the receiver inside here, and also on the top here. And maybe you can take a little extra stamp here, just for some more fun decoration. Here about. So. And it closes up with taking this over, like so. And now you can have it like this, and have maybe an image on the back, or write a more personal message. But I will also show you to make it into a more sort of a card. So yeah, put this aside a bit. So here I cut out the paper that is 6 by 8, and then you need to score it at 4 inch, fold it over. So, and I like to decorate it before I put it on the card. So here I already put on a strip of paper that's from the 8x8 sheet. And I want one more on the top. And here I have a really thin strip. So take get this clip on here. It's really helpful with this bottle here to get the thin glue out. So I can manage to see now how this goes. So, and we can have some images here as well. So I have some leftover fussy cut here that we can use. Let's see, a train maybe, a car, and a lookout world, and maybe this one here. So yeah, we can go for that. So, and I will just glue this on the side here so you can place a tag inside here. I think I go over here. So, and this is a train here. And this I got off from the 6x6 paper pad. So just lift it up a bit here. Globe here. So you see on these tiny pieces it's really helpful. Take it a bit over here, I think. And it's also helpful to have a bit of a wet cloth. For this here. And here it also would be fun to do some stamping or, yeah. Take this little car also. So. And now we can stick a card or tag in here if you like to, like so. So, but I think I just will leave it like that. So now we can glue this on the base here. So I will just use my ATG gun. See if we can line it up like so. I think I need to have it flat, so excuse me if you only see my hair here. So, thereabouts. So now this is finished, and it's really easy and fast to make, and I think the receiver will love it. So on the back side you can also put on some, see if I have a postcard here you can put on. So I can put this on here as well, this way maybe. Here, so I think I just leave it for now. Maybe I glue it on, or maybe this mat. But that depends on how much writing I want to do to the person. So yeah. So thank you so much for watching, everyone, and if you have any questions, please look below the video. There you will find the information how I answer questions. Just click the button show more and then all will come up. And yeah, I hope this was helpful and that you will give it a try. And I wish you all a happy and a great day, and have fun creating. Take care. Bye-bye.